now we're going to some big New York gallery opening, which is being hosted by someone who claims to be related to the original William Shakespeare.
We're on the Broome Street and West Broadway in Soho.
480 Broome Street, NYC, and you can see by the swirly writing that we're going to a place that fancies itself a bit special, darling, fancies itself a little bit swanky. We're talking about art and conversation, darling. Look, there's a picture of the gallery with pictures hanging in it, darling. It's very, very posh. And it says RSVP. It doesn't just say give us a call or hope you can come. It says RSVP, which is very old world. And I'm sure I'm gonna love it.
Okay, you ready? Just go in. Let's do it.
Check it out, check it out.
Tery.
Okay. Valerie Shakespeare.
Hi.
This is Tery.
Hello, Tery. I'm Kate.
Hi, Kate.
Nice to meet you. Yes, indeed. Is it okay that you guys are on camera with me?
Yeah, of course.
What?
Okay.
Where?
You're on TV with
me. It's okay
me?
With you. It's
HBO?
Okay.
Oh,
with
hell
you.
Yeah.
TV?
This is fabulous.
We just,
Do you want me to take your camera? Anything else?
I'll keep this because
these are all made with scraps of metal and metallic pigments. So they really are what they are. They're corroded, colored metals.
But he colors them, right? I mean, they're not. I mean, he paints them.
Yeah. Well, that's the art part.
Yeah.
This is a 19th century fishing boy simulating water coming through it. So there are some references in it.
Movements.
But he has an underwater studio in Bermuda.
You mean he works underwater?
He works underwater. He makes these pieces underwater.
Fantastic.
One of the startling things about these pieces is it comes with this super carbonized coating.
Uh-huh.
And once you take that coating off, it's really hard to get off. Once you take it off, if you haven't done the right thing, you've blown it.
What do you mean you've blown it?
Well, you can't put it back. So it's
on forever.
Yeah, you can't like wipe it off and paint another duck. So it's a scary way to work. I mean, he wanted to make...
So you strip the metal and then it's gone.
You better be right.
You better have done the right piece of stripping. You better have the right piece of rust, otherwise it's just...
This is really heavy and thick, right?
Yeah.
And reinforced edges, but it has these gentle little bulges, which he made with four sticks of dynamite.
Oh my God. Underwater, right?
No, this is another artist.
Oh.
He took it up in the Adirondacks, put the dynamite in it, and blew it up to catch the energy in the bulge of the box.
Uh-huh.
This was in August.
It's there.
This was in August.
It is, actually.
When?
I like the bulge.
He said when the park mountie showed up,
uh-huh,
he knew it was serious in August because they got out of their Land Rover thing and put their hats on.
Excuse me, sure.
So they talked to him, and he knows about explosives. He's got permits.
How come it didn't blow up just because of the nature of the
metal? Well, it's open on the bottom.
Oh, okay,
it went 60
right.
feet in the air.
Oh, shit.
This is made with a shotgun.
Dave Buck,
yeah. This is a Swiss artist.
Uh-huh.
She lives on the Matterhorn in Visp, and her pieces are made entirely out of recycled Swiss Army soap. You can find some hairs that are still in them. Her first show were canvases growing grass out of them.
I love this.
That's cool. These wonderful little seductive holes, mm-hmm, with the lead around them. It's 30-06 rifle. That took a half stick of dynamite to get that wonderful little curve in. I love this piece over here. We were just talking about
box
it today.
With a hole in it?
Well, people are like really curious, you know.
So they look?
Yeah. And with Western honky noses,
yeah,
which is what the piece is all about, you end up with nose prints all around the hole. And the whole thing's constructed to catch your nose print.
I live for breasts. Any kind of nudity, I live for.
I do too.
Do you? I love it. Too. I love all strippers.
I see these incredible breasts right now. I'm going to go like, Tery, look.
Look at the boobs.
Actually, the poverty line is, we don't wear nothing that doesn't show.
She's a DJ. She plays
WDT, La Nueva Amor.
La Nueva
3.1.
La Nueva Amor.
All the time.
All day, all romance, every day.
Latin beat.
I gotta listen to that. Yeah, because you're a little media doggy, right, Ginger?
This is
you're
right.
A little media,
you know,
doggy.
I love
this. This just goes to show that art hasn't gone to the dogs. The dogs have gone to the art.
Every time I say what I do, I'm lying right now. And all these people who think they know me, they don't know me, because I don't know them.
And you think I have that in this
I'm really scared, and I don't know if I'm gonna get out of these woods. I just want to say that I'm really sorry for making everyone come here, and Mom and Dad.
Ordinarily, this is how I would wear this outfit, but Tery was afraid that if I wore this outfit, you'd cut me out.
Actually, my own tits are not that interesting to me, but everybody else's tits.
We collect hair. We collect.
No, it's true.
We collect shell.
It's true.
Your tit are interesting to me.
But not to me. Your tits are interesting.
Believe that. Yes.
Oh, Shelby, your nipple sends huge ripples, waves of time and space, changing like the
art. Wait a minute! Wait
a
minute! Stop the camera.
Now, did you like that? I was on a roll.
I could feel your breath.
Did you feel it?
Yeah, I could feel your breath.
You could feel it. I'll do it again later. All right,
Shelby.
That's okay, so.
She dared me.
The one thing about Valerie and her charming artist husband is that they really understand how important it is to host events, to bring people together, people who would ordinarily never meet.
I have no idea what anyone is saying to me. They're talking about the fucking... I don't know what to say. Things are coming out of my mouth. There are rich people everywhere. I don't know what to say to rich people. If I have even one drink, something bad is gonna happen. Something scary is gonna happen. It's gonna be like this. It's gonna be like this again. Do I smell like dick?
No.
What? And you're worried? I just brought Valerie Tiffany perfume, and if you think that's what that smells like, I'm a little nervous.
You're doing that just to be funny.
No, I'm not.
You're a bad girl. How did you get your job?
I sprayed myself with Lysol before I left the house.
I know that new...
It's coming up now.
No, it's very
fresh. That new
fresh
linen scent, yeah.
It's just like CK1. Just smell me. Do I smell like dick?
No, I think you smell nice.
Oh my God. Thanks.
Sure. She smells great. Hey.
Whatever it was you said.
I just want to toast our hosts with the most, especially for taking me into this family tonight. I feel really honored and privileged that they actually, you know, let me come in and enjoy this dinner with all of you guys and feel the art on the walls and feel the art in the room. And I think it's a really special evening. It's one of the greatest evenings of my time in New York of all time. And as a young Polynesian neophyte in the art scene, I have to say that I'm always going to remember this. And cheers to everybody.
Cheers. Thank you.
Tery and Valerie.
Here's to young Polynesian neophyte.